Hello guys, Ivan here and welcome to a new video. So in this video we will check out the all new 2024 Mercedes GLC Coupe, and this is in AMG line with super exclusive interior. Today we are at AMG Performance Center, Bratislava Lamač. Special thanks for having us here today. And in this video we'll check out the exterior interior and also the infotainment system. But in the later videos I will go also for the drive, so definitely stay tuned for that. Don't forget to like and subscribe and turn on notification bell so you don't miss the driving video. Right, so let's start with the exterior. So this is the all new generation of the new GLC. And this is the GLC Coupe. We have also GLC SUV, but this one is the more stylish version. Also, here is the key fob to the vehicle, the all new Mercedes style key fob. And here we have very nice spec, in my opinion. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. This is actually the most expensive paint which you can get on the GLC Coupe, and this is the graphite gray Magna. So it is this matte gray, but very, very dark gray. So this one is more like almost black, but it's not black, because as you can see here, it's a gray color. If it would be sunshine, it was like a few minutes ago. Hopefully it will be soon again. I will show you how this car looks under sunshine. I want to show you finally. So check it out. The car looks really great in the sunshine. It really pops this color. If it's overcast, you cannot see it immediately, but here on the sunshine you can see how it's glossy. The paint has also like a flick. This flicks like a metallic paint, but check it out, it's matte. So it has also these metallic flicks. So over the metallic they do like a matte coating, satin coating. So it's better looking than the matte wrap, we can say. More like a satin glossy. And you can see all of the shapes. Here is like a little brighter because it stands out on the power bulges. And yeah, really, really nice in this graphite gray Magna. Really looks like almost like AMG, I would say. So fantastic looking for sure. The well-known color also from AMGs and other cars. It was really popular, like on the four-door and some other models as well on the G-Class. So yeah, very popular this color. So Magna means matte paint. It's also manufactured paint, so a special line of the paints. So the all-new GLC Coupe, to me, it looks like a more grown-up version of the previous GLC, which was already really great-looking car, but this one is even better-looking, in my opinion. Let me know what you think. Most of the people which I talked to really love this new GLC SUV and also the coupe. So we have this sloping roof, let's check it out from the side and also from the back. So you can see how it slopes down. We can go and check out the back. So it really slopes quite a lot. So you can see that the end of the car is basically with the lower line of the window line in same level. Here you can see also one line, like a cut on the matte paint, you can see it much better. So it ends here and starts somewhere somewhere here. And then it blends into the rear doors. So then we have the new tail lamps. These are also all new. We have this one curved LED stripe here. Then we have the engine version on the left side and 4MATIC on the right side. This one is the 4MATIC version, as you can see, and also Mercedes logo in the middle. All badges and logo are in chrome. Also the exhaust tips are in chrome here. These are cosmetic, they are not functional, so yeah, the exhaust is cosmetic, as you can see. But to me it looks great, better than if it wouldn't be here anything. A real exhaust is down to the ground, directed. Also here we have these nice cutouts. Usually with the AMG variants, with aero package you have here these flaps. Additionally with the aero package. So yeah, this configuration. The spec for me is a really nice one. Also, as you can see, that we have the night package, because the window trim here is in high gloss black, and also rear windows are darkened, tinted, so these are privacy glass as well. Front are not allowed here in Europe, so only back. And also on the GLC now you have painted these wheel arches in body color, so the car looks really sporty. And here in the middle you can have either sidestep or this like a cutout in the middle. So as you can see here, this one is in this matte black paint, so it's matte black. This one is matte dark graphite gray, so it's a difference in colors. And here are the wheels. So these are multi-spoke high gloss black with the aluminium outer rim, silver outer rim. Front 255 40 R20, and these are Continental Eco Contact 6Q MO, Mercedes original. Also brake calipers are in silver with ventilated brake discs. Overall you can choose different wheels. These are nice in my opinion. I like these. The rears should be wider. Also in terms of the tires, manufacturers should use like not only one but multiple brands, so every car could have a different brand. 285 40 R20 is the rear tire size, and they stick out quite a lot as you can see here, so they have like a nice stance. Whole car looks like it's bigger car basically. Obviously if you put this next to the GLE you can see that it's not as big, but it's not either like a small car. You can see that this is a mid-size SUV. So the GLA is the smallest one, then we have GLC SUV and GLC coupe, then GLE SUV and coupe, and then GLS is the largest in the Mercedes-Benz lineup, and of course the G-Class, but that's more like an off-road car, not an SUV. From the front we have the all-new LED lights, the same as on the GLC SUV. One LED stripe with two smaller, so they are not completely straight as you can see. And here we have the very nice lights, and these are actually the best ones, digital light, which you can get Mercedes-Benz, the latest technology. And they are also like a little bit connected to the grille, as you can see here. So overall, in my opinion, the car looks much more sporty from the front. It looks really aggressive. Also we have these vents here on the side. These are the air curtains, so the air is directed here from the front towards the side. So here is nicely hidden, but you can see there the opening. So overall really great design. It looks definitely like a larger car if you ask me. So solid improvement with the only generation of the GLC. I think this will be really popular as it was before, so I expect this car to sell quite a lot. Also we have the all-new grille. This one has the small Mercedes-Benz stars in chrome in this case, and surrounding is in gloss black. The outer rim of the Mercedes star is in chrome, as well as the Mercedes star. This one is flat because we have this turning here. The badge is actually flat because behind the badge we have the radar Distronic. So it uses not only cameras but also the radar. As you can see here, a camera, so it works in conjunction. Also here we have the very nice heads-up display with the large opening, and also these power domes on the front hood, so the whole car looks much more sporty. So if you would ask me, this looks almost like an AMG here in AMG line. So in my opinion, great improvement. Also the car looks like a muscular in terms of the stance, so the front fenders are like bulged out, you can see here. So really, really new, trendy, and great design in my opinion. Also these cutouts, here, they very like, looks like an AMG, and also have these smaller like flaps which redirect the air into the air curtain. Also if you have different color, then this part is not painted, only here in the middle, and this like closes here the vent, like on the AMGs. The middle lip is in gloss black. Also, let's check it out from the side in the sunshine here. But you can see this is a gloss black in the window trim, and this is a graphite gray, so it's a little bit more light, but overall it's very dark. So there are those colors like anthracite. This one is even more than that, actually. So really, really beautiful car in my opinion. Also, the tail lamps are like a smoked, you can see it here. The reverse light is more tinted. Also, the whole light is like a tinted more. The lights are connected here with this like a light bar, but it doesn't light up. So it actually serves as an like a design piece which connects lights together. So the GLC comes as a mild hybrid or plug-in hybrid version. So we have 2.0 liters diesel available in some markets like Europe, and also we have available the petrol, either as a mild hybrid or plug-in hybrid. Mild hybrid you don't charge, it's 48 volt system, and plug-in hybrid you can charge, and then you have electric range which you can use as well. So that's the plug-in hybrid. This one is, this particular car is the mild hybrid 2.0 liter diesel engine, GLC to 20D 4MATIC. Alright, so let's open the hood. So you need to pull the lever here. So here is a lever on the left side next to the star. And yeah, the diesel engine is actually more loud if you have a hood open, but if it's closed, it's much more silent. So let's turn it off for now. This is also a really nice spec. Check out the stitching. I will show you shortly. Top spec also in the interior. So here we have the options of 2.0 liters. So we have GLC, all are 4MATIC, so all versions are all-wheel drive. So we have GLC 200 2.0 liter petrol engine, then this one, GLC 220 diesel. Then we have GLC 300 2.0 liter petrol engine, more powerful than the 200. And then we have also GLC 300 diesel, which is more powerful than this one. And also we have the plug-in hybrid, so 300 DE, which is a diesel plug-in hybrid. Then we have 400 E, which is petrol plug-in hybrid. So let me know which one would be your favorite. So this one is 197 horsepower, and the sprint from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour or 62 miles per hour takes 8.1 seconds. The top speed is 225 kilometers per hour, and miles will be on the screen. For me, doesn't actually matter that much what kind of engine do you get for this car. It's most of the time comfortable daily driver, so it doesn't matter that much. All of the engines are mated to 9G Tronic, but if you need more acceleration, then obviously you need more powerful version as well for the GLC. So that's basically it. On the left side we have also some heat shields, and you can see very, very nice in terms of the design. Also, this is mounted longitudinally, so you can see here that inline four for the rear-wheel drive based cars. Also, for the GLC, we have an optional air suspension, Airmatic, so even more comfortable than adjustable suspension. Really amazing levels of comfort, and I cannot wait to try it here in the GLC coupe. And also, we have the active rear axle steering, so the rear wheels can steer to give you better maneuverability in parking, and also in sporty driving they will actually move in different direction, so that's also really good. Also for the maneuverability in parking, they will do opposite, and if you are on the higher speed, then it will do same steering as the front, so therefore it will lengthen the wheelbase, and with parking it will shorten the wheelbase if it will steer in opposite direction. We can check it out as well, how it works. Alright guys, so now let's check out the boot capacity and boot of the new GLC coupe. So here we have 545 liters. I believe this is over 19 cubic feet. You can check it out on the screen, exact numbers. And the GLC SUV is 620 liters. So we have about 75 liters less of a boot space, which is more than 10%, but less than 20%, we can say, which is not that bad. So here, actually, this is my backpack and tripod. So here is this roller cover, which we can close. And if you close the boot, then you cannot see what is on the inside. And basically, this is how much room do you have if you have this roller cover. So in terms of the boot, it's a little bit less than the GLC SUV, but still manageable, I would say, for daily driving, depending how much space do you actually need. So on the left side, here we have the buttons where you can lower actually the car. Also, we can fold seats, so let's check it out. It actually falls automatically with the gravity. It's not electrical like in GLE, for example, but it's not a big deal. Basically, almost straight, we can say, check it out. So quite a lot of space you can put this away, the roller, and then you have a lot of space for sure. So all in all, really great in terms of the practicality. Check it out. And you can fold it back very easily like this. Also, the seatbelt here is tucked in this very nice place. Check it out. Pretty cool. We will check the interior shortly. Also here underneath the boot floor, if you open this, is like a cover, boot cover. So underneath, check it out, underneath here we have additional storage space, quite a lot. Check it out, so you can put some bags here, etc. Also there we have a food box for the food, for the groceries, and yeah, some first aid kit, etc. Basic accessories, tow hook and triangle here. So yeah, basic stuff. So all in all, really great in my opinion. Also you can get like a cargo net and connect here on each corner and then secure luggage underneath, so it's not like flying around if you have only one bag, for example. Also you can tow with this car, so this has a automatic tow hook, check it out. So you can tow a trailer with this car. And retract, you can retract this also automatically, which is great. And you can close it here with the button electrically, or with your foot, with your key fob, etc. So depending how you like this, but most of the people open it like that. Also, I believe, not sure if the car needs to be turned off, but you can open it here with your foot as well. Yes, check it out. So you need to not swipe, but swing with your foot. I usually just press the button here. You need to train the swing motion. And we have tinted window here as well in the back. No wiper, because on the coupes you don't have a wiper, only on the hatchbacks and SUVs. This one is the SUV coupe, so it doesn't have a wiper, and it would look bad, I think, if here would be wiper, so it's not here. So yeah, very, very cool in terms of the rear and also the boot space. Alright, so now let's check out the interior. Here we have also keyless entry. So you just need to place hand here, it will open and close. You need to tap here as well, so it will, as you can see, also you can turn off the engine and close the door like this. So now we can open it, or if you press, then you can close it. So that's a pretty cool feature. So now you can see here the all new cockpit for the GLC coupe, and here we have a really beautiful spec. So all new AMG steering wheel. This one is the super sport style. Let's turn on the engine so the battery doesn't die. So as you can see, we have the new layout with the AMG line super sport steering wheel, as well as the driver display, middle central screen, middle tunnel, and also these beautiful new AMG line seats. These are actually the most expensive one which you can get, the black Napa leather. And these black Napa leather have really nice stitching. It's not like diamond, you can see one diamond, or maybe two, but really nice one, and high quality leather, as you can see, for a GLC. This is a great level of quality. Also, here you have a button where you can move the headrest forward and backwards. I will show you on the passenger seat. So we can hop inside. Also, here we have Mercedes-Benz door seals illuminated in the night, AMG floor mats, and also the pedals which are aluminum with rubber dots. Also here we have some door packets. This is emergency vest and place for water bottle. You can also open the tailgate here with this button. Burmester surround sound system, really nice aluminum panel here with the buttons. You can fold the windows, and then we have also seat heating here and three memory positions. Then we have also buttons to control the seat electrically. You can move the seat, also three memory positions and seat heating. I can close the door as well, and very nice stitching here at the door panel as well. So let's hop inside. The door closing sound, really nice and high quality sound. All right, and this is how the front looks from the back. Let me know how you like this. Okay, so as you can see here, here is the layout of the cockpit. You can move the steering wheel electronically here with the button on the side. And as well, we have something what many people love, and that's it, can you guess? The panoramic sunroof. So here we have this like a see-through cover, but it's enough to not have a do not burn your head. Then you can also open it like this, this roller cover. And thanks to the coupe shape, panoramic sunroof is not fully because it's not physically possible, but as you can see, it's quite large. A little bit extends to the rear seats. Behind the B pillar, we have like 1/3 of the panoramic sunroof. Also, you can open it like this on the ventilation, so you have this small gap for vent. That's just the voice assistant. And you can also open it as well fully. So check it out. You can open it like this. The glass is also a little bit tinted, but when it's too sunny, you need to close the shade. You can burn your head. Here we have this net, also helps with aerodynamics and can catch some insect if they fly there. So yeah, overall, I want to show also how the car looks from the outside with the sunroof open. So here we have the design. This is the aero part, which I was talking about. This is the opening for the car, and it sticks out a little bit like this. Let me know how you like this. Many people love actually panoramic sunroof. On the GLC, I would say it's almost must have, because it's then easier to sell the car with the panoramic sunroof. Without the sunroof, it could be not difficult, but could be longer to sell the car. It's because most of the clients want sunroof, GLC coupe or GLC SUV, doesn't matter which SUV, they all want sunroof. Makes the car brighter, especially when it's not sunny, because it, when it's sunny, it could be too much, like could be like too hot. But in winter, fall, also in spring, could be nice to have more sunlight when it's not super sunny, and you want to have a more bright environment in the cabin. And you can also close it like this here if you slide. Also, this panel has illumination, as you can see here. Panel is came first to the S-Class, now it's filtered down to the C-Class and also GLC. And, we have here the sunroof with the mirror and light. Also, we have here the microphone and the handle, so that's also nice to have. Also, the passenger has the handle, but the rear passengers don't have it. You can move the headrest here with this toggle. If you press this, you can move it forward or backwards, which I think is nice, so you can find your ideal sitting position. And here is a close-up of these seats. Really nice stitching, I really like this. And you can pick different colors, but this one is more like a sporty, but also elegant with this stitching. Sporty because of black, but it's not your typical black interior, which is pretty cool. Also, in terms of the trim, I think this is my favorite in terms of all trims which are available. And this one is like a wood with open pores and also with aluminum lines. So this is like a dark brown, I would say. Very nice in terms of the color. And also we have here these aluminum lines. So the car looks really, really stylish, like a deck on the yacht, I would say, something like that. Also, it's like a little bit rough, so it gives the car more elevated look and definitely more it looks more expensive whole car. So this would be one of the top choices if I would spec the car. You can also see here the heads-up display, and you can check it out as well. So here we have the driver screen, and here we have the central screen, and the storage space in the glove compartment, glove box. So as you can see, it's pretty deep, and you can store many stuff there. Also here in the middle, you can get this in different colors, but not this in this one. It is like a metal, in those like a metal sort of colors, or this piano black. So with this probably piano works the best. If you have different trim, then maybe also get this one in different one, or match, you can match it as well. So here we have two cup holders. These are adjustable, and you can also, I believe, this one, if you press, yes, it folds out, check it out. So you can may have more space for drinks or for some other stuff. Here we have some storage space, and wireless charger for a phone is actually there. And you can see here that we have USB-C port as well. We have wireless Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and you can close it like this to hide everything. You need to keep microfiber cloth here in the car to wipe it so it looks with less fingerprints. Then we have also here the middle tunnel with the armrest, and this one opens up like this. And then we have also this small like box. You can also take this out actually. Check it out. So you don't need to use this, but you can keep something on the bottom. You have also two USB-C ports, and then you can keep something here, like, I don't know, maybe coins, something like that, garage opener, some other bits and pieces, so depending what you want to carry in the car. So I think it's actually useful, this small box. So definitely useful. On the right side, next to the driver display, here we have the engine start stop button. Also, you can turn off the auto start stop with the button underneath. For the MG line super sport steering wheel, I will just put this so it doesn't blow on the microphone the air. So here with this all new super sport steering wheel, here we have this beautiful design with horizontal two bars, and these are two vertical ones, the largest MB Star ever fitted to a steering wheel. And the steering wheel is thicker here on the sides, Nappa leather, so full quality in terms of the leather quality. And I really like this one, really stunning in terms of the steering wheels, probably my favorite one. So with these touch buttons, you need to get used to this, but it's not that big of a deal in my opinion. So yeah. So for the adaptive cruise control, the Distronic, you can actually change the settings here. So for example, the distance with the vehicle in front of you, you can change this, and also speed limiter if you want, set the speed, you can reset and also cancel. Home button, you can change the driver display, so we can check it out. If you press here, we have a classic, sport, understated, and then if you swipe right, we have navigation, assistance, off-road and service as well. So we can check these. The understated, it's really understated, we can say. If you press here on the OK, then we have different colors which you can choose from of this display. It's really basic. You have a speed here and actually time on the right, and also here you have like only radio. You can press here on the home and have different layout here, and it will stay the same for the driver screen. Then we have the sport one, which looks like this. Also on the right side here we have the engine data, on the left side we have the G-force. And here on the left side, newton meters, and on the right side, we have kilowatts. In the middle, we had the RPMs. Classic, you have two dials, and you can swipe in the middle here and change what is on the screen. So first, we have the odometer. Then we have the from start, the consumption, then from reset. Then we have the eco display, the consumption, attention assist, radio, and also the navigation. Then we have the navigation, you can have it on full screen as well. And then we have the assistance, so you can watch how the Distronic works on the road. Then we have the off-road, which is an all-new menu. And as you can see the steering wheel. If you steer, you can see the degree there. Also you can see here the degrees if you are in the off-road here as well. I can see also GPS and where we are heading. So we have here southwest at the moment, and also have elevation here as well. So very nice, looks like a sand, very cool. Then service, this one shows you the temperature in the tires, tire pressure, AdBlue, the only for the diesel. Next service, when is next service, then engine oil level, and also you can see here the coolant temperature. So here we can see the coolant temperature and also engine oil level. So that's really useful also for the service. And if you swipe up here, then you can see the heads-up display. So we have minimal, then we can see the sport, standard, off-road, eco settings, and we can turn it off. So I'm just going to show now. So here we can see this one is the sport one. This one is minimal. This one is the standard. And this one is for the off-road, a large one. So you can see like three dials here, very cool. But could be too much, depending, you can change it up. Then we have eco display settings. So if you press on it, then you can change the height of the heads-up display, which is useful, and also you can change the brightness. So it can go to -5 during night time if you don't really want to have one which is really bright. You can turn it down, and then heads-up display, if you press, you can turn it off completely if you don't use it, etc. So that's also a possibility. Here on the left side we have toggle for the lights. So we have automatic lights, then we have the main headlights, these are the parking lights, and then on each side you have a parking light as well. You can release the parking brake here with the button here, and that's basically it from this side. This display, the central display, you can operate also here with the button. You can swipe like this, or obviously you can swipe with your finger like this. So we can check it out. So here we have the, on the top we have always the main content. On the top here we have the profiles here, and on the bottom here we have always the AC. So you can press here on the navigation, and we have here the new navigation from the S-Class, brand new. This is the NTG7, the latest MBUX system. Then we have the phone. You can connect two phones actually to the car. Then radio, you have multiple radios. Also we have DAB Plus, which is a digital radio. Then we have the media. So you can connect your phone, play a media. Then apps, Mercedes Me app, weather browser, you have like games also, pairs, shuffle pack, and Sudoku. So you can play this if you have time. Then we have Mercedes Me store, so you can purchase some of the features as well to the car. So that's also a possibility. Probably you need to be signed up with your account. And then comfort. So here we have seat. These have seat kinetics, so the seat can move a little bit forwards, backwards, or up and down just a little bit, not to mess up with your driving position. You can do that also for the driver. Only backrest, you can choose maybe only surface and how long should it last. So this is like an alternative for the massage, which is, I think, cool idea. And you can position the seat automatically here as well. Then we have the ambient light, which has the monochrome or multicolor options. So you can choose from the 64 colors. And then we have multicolors. So ocean blue, Miami rose, Malibu sunset, burning blue, Venice pink, chrome shine, red moon, jungle green, ultramarine, fresh cyan, racy yellow, and racy orange. And then with brightness, you can see that we have 20, that's the maximum, and effects, warning when exiting, climate, multicolor animation, so that's also pretty cool. Then here we have the off-road menu, so here you can see how the suspension works. Also, you can lower the vehicle with the dynamic button here, we will check this. Also, here we have something unique, so you have actually front camera image. So if you drive forward here with the transmission lever, Then the car will scan the road and you will see what is actually under the road. So that's really great for the off-road situations and really, really great. Then we have the traction control manual for the off-road and also hill descent control. You can also increase the ride height here with this button. So now the car is rising, you can see there. And you can turn it off and the car will be lowering. Also, you can see here the suspension, then the tire temperature, then we have the position in the also satellite, check it out, pretty cool. Then we have engine data, temperature of the engine, transmission, and suspension can also change here, basically the same. And you can see elevation here where we are heading as well. And yeah, that's the off-road menu. Then we have info. So here we can see the consumption over 7 minutes, half an hour, 90 minutes, 3 hours. And then we have vehicle, accelerator, brake, and angles as well. You can see the car can go to minus 1, minus 2, or plus 1. Then we have engine. So here we can see torque, power, and boost pressure. And also the temperature of the transmission and oil. So very cool. If I add a little bit of the, you can see how it rises. Can you see? Just a little bit. So that's in terms of the info. Then we have settings. So here with the settings, we have the assistance. So we have driving. So in terms of the driving, we have active distance assist. So this one, the function maintains the set speed and reacts to vehicles in front, speed limits, curves in the road, etc. Then we have the adapt speed limit, route-based speed adaptation, based on dynamic select, braking, acceleration, comfortable or dynamic, you can choose this. Then active steering assist. The function helps you to drive in the center of the lane using moderate steering intervention. Active lane change assist, you can turn this on. And where possible and permitted, the function actively steers when changing lanes. Downhill speed regulation DSR. So this will help you downhill to maintain correct speed. Then collision avoidance, we have ESP. You can have this in on or off. Then we have active brake assist. This function can help you minimize the risk of collision with vehicle, cyclists or pedestrians, or reduce the effects of accidents. We have early, medium, and late. Then active lane keeping assist. This function is intended to protect you from the leaving your lane unintentionally. If you approach the lane markings or the edge of the carriageway, you are warned by a vibration in the steering wheel and receive a course correcting steering intervention. And you can set warning and steering intervention. It can be early, medium, late, and advanced. When advanced support is activated, the function also reacts to broken lane markings, which is great as well. So I really like this because the markings are not clear everywhere. Then we have the lane keeping assist. Then we have the active blind spot assist. This function warns you of vehicles detected at the rear alongside the vehicle if a risk of collision is detected. Course correcting braking takes place. Then we have assistance, traffic sign assist. By pressing the mute button on the steering wheel for an extended duration, you can activate, deactivate the acoustic speed warning at any time. So we have speed limit warning, visual, or audible, and audible. Further warnings, visual, audible, and acoustic signal for the new speed limit. Then we have traffic light view. This is really useful. The function assists you at the junctions, controlled by traffic lights, by displaying a video image which gives you a convenient view of the traffic lights. Here we have you can show the traffic light view in automatic mode or on request. And then attention assist. This function supports you on a long monotonous journeys and suggests taking a break if it detects signs of fatigue or an increasing lack of concentration. And the warning threshold could be sensitive or standard. Then we have camera, speed-based activation. You can also open the camera cover, so you can also use this. So here in parking, we have parking space in camera image in R, set warning tones, audio fade out, time of warning, and maneuvering assistant. driveway assist, warning for cross traffic ahead and warning from crossing traffic behind. Very, very useful as well features. So then vehicle, we have driving. So here we have winter tire limit, snow chain mode. Then we have manual shifting, automatic filling, station surge and trailer drive. Then comfort, we have easy entry and exit feature, roller, roof roller, sunblind, occupant protection, bell adjustment. Then we have open close. So here we have automatic locking, acoustic lock, automatic mirror folding, standby mode, and then dynamic select. You can ask when starting and you can change your individual mode, drive, suspension, steering, ESP and the sound as well. And lights, this is for the digital lights. We have dynamic low beam, then welcome farewell projection. You can have the digital rain, the star wave off. I think star wave is cool. We can set it, and then support projection, certain situation, digital light projects additional information onto the road surface, so it can be spotlight warning and alerts. Very, very cool. And low beam automatic right side traffic or left side traffic, interactive lighting, we checked this before, as well as the ambient lighting. And then here in the system we have here the voice assistant, Hi Mercedes, then online recognition, activated or contact upload for online recognition, then proactivity, certain situation the voice assistant will be active even without being directly addressed. For example, don't forget your phone. Then we have suggestions. The function is only available after activating a personal user profile. Then display and display messages. Here we have the display brightness. You can increase this to maximum. You can also have it on minus 10 during night time. Then activate, deactivate display. You can turn off the display or system. Home screen can be classic or the zero layer. Here in the zero layer, basically you have always navigation like this, and here you have like a device, podcast, music, etc., radio, and some other things which you use the most. If you hold the home button here, if you hold it, then you can switch to classic if you prefer this. Then language, you can choose your language. We have many languages here. Hopefully yours is here as well. You can see the Arabic, Chinese, etc. So many languages. Then keyboard, handwriting. So we have keyboard languages, handwriting recognition, and reset my dictionary. Control elements, acoustic feedback and touch control. You can change this as well. Audio, we can change to greeting tone, factoring phone, voice output and entertainment. With the Burmester, we have personal sound profile or pure or 3D sound. We can set also the equalizer, the bass, mids and treble, balance and fader. You can move this as well how you want, only for the front seat, for the driver for example, and you can customize this how you want. Sound focus could be also on front seat, also only for the rear seat, or it can be for all seats. And loudness normalization, so here you can see the perceived volume can be low, medium and high, so it can change when you are somewhere when it's louder. It will add a little bit of the music, which is a little bit of the volume it will add, which is really great. Here internet and Bluetooth, so we can manage internet access. And then we have MBUX hotspot, then Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, data protection, system pin, and you can transmit vehicle position, time and date. You can see this as well. And software update, it would be here as well. In the info, you can see the owner's manual, system information and legal stuff. So yeah, that's in terms of the settings here. Then smartphone integration, this is for the Apple CarPlay or Android Auto. Basically, it's on the full screen here. So really, really great. Here, if you press on the icon, you can select profiles, synchronize data online with the Mercedes Me, delete usage data, and you can select the user as well. And here you can search, and on the star, here you have the favorite stuff. So you have a consumption here, a traffic, route overview, browser, you can turn off the display, manual, or add favorite. So you can see, you can add a lot of different stuff here. So overall, really great in my opinion, in this terms of the infotainment system, the latest MBUX. Under the display, here we have this bar with the buttons. So the first one is the dynamic. If you press on it, you can see the DSR is off, okay? So you can see here that we have the off-road mode. The driving systems are being adapted, therefore use only the drive program for driving off-road and not on public roads. Then we have the eco, then comfort mode. In this mode the car starts. Then we have the sport, but don't use this with the roof load. Then we have individual, where you can change a bunch of stuff. So for example, the drive can be eco, comfort or sport. Then the suspension can be also comfort or sport. Steering, comfort or sport. And ESP, comfort or sport. And sound, comfort or sport as well. So you can customize the individual mode as well. And here, if you press on the camera button, you will see we have 360 camera here. So we have the front image. Press here, then we have front wide. Here we have the rear, also rear wide. And also for the tow hook, we have it as well. Then from one side, you can check out the wheels also from the other side. And then you have auto, so it can work automatically. And you can basically store the GPS position here, so it's saved in the future. If the camera will be automatically activated here, if you arrive at this location, which we saved right now. Also, you can move the car here. And you can see it here. So very, very cool that you can check it out here in 360. So here next to it, we have a car button. This one is for the functions like heads-up display, car wash mode, snow chains, you can raise vehicle level, manual shifting, and some other, so very cool. Then hazard lights, we have it here. Then fingerprint sensor, so you can open your profile, and with the fingerprint you can turn it off. You can mute the volume, and here is the volume as well, volume top, volume toggle we can say. In terms of the AC, here we have the climate menu. So if you press here, you have a menu for the first row of seats or second row of seats. So you can change this as well. So this is like a 4-zone AC unit. Also have AC button here, you can sync as well. So that's pretty cool. Then you have a defrost on the front and rear. You can close the circulation of the air, which is really useful that it's here. When someone has like a smoking exhaust, etc., then you can close this and you can have both on auto. And here with the auto, you can also change the level, how much should the fan work in automatic mode. So that's also very cool. The AC is pretty quiet, I would say. It blows the air softly in the slowest setting here in the level 1 of the auto vent. So here in the level 1, the cannot hear the AC, very cool. Alright, so now it's time to check out the rear section of the vehicle, rear seats. Here we have the bench for 3-seat configuration, but mostly the most comfortable will be obviously for 2, as many cars on the market. Here we have also the armrest, which you can fold like this. And you can see how much space we have here, you can hop inside. Alright, so I'm here in the back seat, we can close the door. Solid sound, let's try it one more time. Very solid. Here we have also Burmester, check it out, very nice. Also seat heating, 3 levels. Very nice ambient stripe here around. And also here in the door handle behind it, really cool. Some door pockets, also place for a water bottle. Burmester speaker, how gorgeous is this. Absolutely fantastic, check it out. In terms of the legroom, I have about, the seat is like curved here in the middle, so I have more space actually. If I sit like this, I would usually sit. Here it's rounded, as you can see, so it's more comfortable. And I can sit very, very relaxed here. Also, I have a lot of space. If I see it like this, we have, if you have three passengers, then I have about this much space. So you can see here, this is about 5-6 centimeters, about 2 inches, maybe a little bit more than that. So overall, I think it's doable. It's not like super spacious, but it's not like uncomfortable for sure. So yeah, so a little bit larger than on the previous generation, so even more space. Also, here we can see that we have the camera for the AC. Here you can change the temperature and also auto, you can change direction. Also, here you can close or open the vents. Check it out. Very cool, same as in the front. Check it out. Now the sunroof opens. Really cool, so much light now coming to the car. Really bright. Also, here is the armrest, good for 2 arms. And if you press one more time, you can see you have storage space for a phone or tablet. And if you press one more time, then you will reveal the hidden cup holders. They are also adjustable. And you can fold it back as well. And here you can see the seats, very nice stitching, same as in the front. Also comfortable. Here we have Isofix for a child seat. And buckles as well. Here we have the middle one stored in the middle, so really comfortable to put the feet under the seat. Also, here we have some storage space as well. On the top here we don't have the handle, but we have here the airbag, and as you can see also we can store the seat belt there, so that's also pretty cool. All right guys, so in terms of the headroom, I have, you can see that the roof is shaped here, so we have more headroom, so that's actually really smart. And in terms of the headroom, I have about, right now I'm sitting straight, so I have about nice 6 centimeters, that's about 2 inches, even more than that, so pretty good in my opinion. I'm 186 centimeters, maybe 87, and that's 6 feet 1 inch, maybe a little bit more, so this kind of height. So I think even for taller people than me this could be manageable. But still, for coupe shape, I think this is an amazing result here with the headroom. So yeah, definitely as a passenger you can feel that the roof is sloping down, but it's not like something uncomfortable, depending who you ask. SUV will be definitely more spacious in terms of the feeling for the rear passengers. So if you plan to transport adults, which are very tall, then the SUV would be a better option, but otherwise, for kids, for example, it will be plenty of space for sure. Alright guys, so that's it for this video. Let me know in the comment section down below how do you like the new GLC Coupe. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more episodes. Thank you much for your support, and I will see you soon in the next video. Have a wonderful day.